The medical fraternity has come out tough on the government officials, whom they accuse of wasting billions of taxpayers' money seeking health care abroad, yet the same services can be offered by medical experts in the country. They are demanding that instead such huge amounts of funds be dedicated to the government referral hospitals to serve more Ugandans who can't afford treatment outside the country. According to research, government spends more than 30 billion shillings annually on treatment of public officials abroad. Speaking to journalists today at Mulago in Kampala, the doctors under the umbrella body of Uganda Medical Association argued that these funds are too much to be used on only a few people. They are demanding that the government regulates this whole system so that only those government officials who've been referred by Mulago National Referral Hospital can be offered funds by the government for treatment abroad.
There are many hospitals in Uganda which are supposed to have consultants and senior consultants, but they are not there. And we have a few examples among many, like Dira Regional Referral Hospital, without a single consultant, and yet these ones are required. Kayunga Regional Referral Hospital, they are not there. So we need to utilize this money and employ these people to serve Ugandans.
The medical fraternity has also sounded an alarm over the growing number of unemployed professional doctors in the country, despite the shortage of health workers in government hospitals. With a lift on the temporary suspension on recruitment of health workers, they have made several recommendations, including 1. All regional and national referral hospital directors should immediately provide information on available positions to the Health Services Commission for advertisement and recruitment. Parliament should allocate a budget for doctor recruitment in local governments. Parliament should collaborate with Uganda Medical Association and stakeholders to create internship and senior house officer terms of service to end recurring strikes.
We have a very huge human resource gap. There are some facilities which are really understaffed to the tune of only 20% positions occupied. When you look at hospitals like Moroto, Kayunga, Yumbe, there are very few health workers, and yet the regional referral hospitals serving a very big population, more than 3 million people. Those ones which have tried to employ doctors and other health workers at least have 63%. But on average in Uganda, our employment capacity in health, government health facilities is around 42%. This gap was much more realized and became imminent to everyone during the time of COVID-19, when our leaders, the good leaders, could not seek for care outside Uganda. They also became concerned because they could see people were dying, and now they were very alert to see how is our healthcare system. Are these Ugandan doctors able to treat us so that we don't die as big people?
We appreciate them coming to us and getting our feedback, but we want them to use the feedback that we gave them to ensure that our internship is actually a smooth one and a good one. Secondly, I would like to talk about the absorbing of health workers as they finish their internship. This was actually supposed to start last year, but it didn't start. We are still appealing to the Parliament of Uganda and the President of this country, as he stated that it shall start. Let them absorb us into the healthcare systems. Let them give us the job employments. Let us enjoy the profession very well.
Over 2,000 doctors remain unemployed. Only a few are surviving in the private sector, while some have moved to other countries for work. Report by Jalia Namuaya for the news.